as you know, when Julio Cesar Chavez fought Pernell Whitaker, the walk-up on that day alone was unbelievable. So we're expecting a lot of people from across the border to come over and support their very own Saul Canelo Alvarez. This bout is a unification fight. It's a 12-round fight for the WBC and WBA, and also the vacant Ring Magazine Super Welterweight World Championship. We're happy to announce the co-main event will be the up-and-coming fighter from Texas, Omar Figueroa Jr. versus Abner Cotto, which will be a 10-rounder for the vacant WBC Silver Lightweight title. And as you know, this event is taking place at the Alamo Dome, promoted by Golden Boy Promotions and Canelo Promotions. And I also want to thank Leija and Bata Promotions, who have been doing an incredible, incredible job. Also happy to announce that Miguel Cotto also is helping us promote this event with Omar Figueroa and Abner Cotto. This event is being sponsored by Corona and AT&T. Thank you very much. And as always, thank you very much to Showtime Championship Boxing. This event will be beginning at 10 p.m. Eastern, 7 p.m. Pacific, and the preliminary bouts will air on Showtime Extreme at 8 p.m. Eastern. Tickets are still available, obviously. There are tickets priced at $25 and $10, and we've also, because of the high demand, are able to open up some bleacher packs, which will be added to the setup, enabling us to open up seats which are priced at $150 and $100 on the floor. So April 20th, fights will begin at 4:30 p.m. Live there at the Alamo Dome. The doors will open at 3:30 p.m. And so let me introduce to you, he hails out of Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico. He is the WBC Super Welterweight World Champion. He has been a pro since 2005. And he started professionally at the age of 15. And right now, at the age of 22, he's obviously the Mexico's champion and current boxing superstar. Let me introduce to you the champion at 154 pounds, Saul Canelo Alvarez. Saul.
Gracias, Oscar. Bueno, pues estoy muy contento porque ya se acerca la hora de la pelea y estamos más que listos. Y contento con toda la respuesta de los medios, de la gente, y espero dar lo mejor ahí en el cuadrilátero para que salgan satisfechos.
He says he's very happy. The time is near. He likes the response that all the fans and the media have given him. He's very, very motivated and willing, ready to give his best once he steps into that ring come Saturday, the 20th.
Okay, great. Let's go ahead and open it up, operator.
If you'd like to ask a question or have a comment, please press star 1 on your telephone keypad. This will place your question in the order it was received. Again, if you'd like to ask a question or have a comment, please press star 1 on your telephone keypad now. All right, and we'll go with our first question. This is coming from Lance Pugmire from Los Angeles Times.
Hi, Canelo. How are you doing today?
Very good. You?
Very good. Hey, I just wanted to ask you, I mean, do you think that a victory in this fight against Trout makes it a no-brainer that your next fight should be against Floyd Mayweather Jr.? And also on that, what does it mean to you to, you know, be considered, like Oscar said, you know, Mexico's champion and boxing superstar in that country now? Do you think that you really have elevated to that spot? Thank you very much.
Canelo, la pregunta es que una victoria sobre Austin Trout te impulsaría y sientes que te impulsaría ya a una pelea con Mayweather?
Bueno, mira.
Y la segunda pregunta es que Oscar menciona que eres ya el ídolo, la estrella de México. ¿Qué se siente? ¿Crees que sí ya llegaste a ese nivel de superestrellato? ¿Y qué se siente estar ahí?
Bueno, mira, yo ahorita nomás estoy enfocado en Austin Trout. Obviamente, estamos pensando nada más en ganar y si Dios quiere vamos a salir ganadores. Pero estamos pensando nada más en eso. Ya después de la pelea, pues, ya será otra cosa y hacer planes, ¿no? Pero por ahora, pues, estamos nada más enfocados en esta pelea. Y, pues, lo otro, pues, a mí me da mucho orgullo y motivación que alguien como Oscar diga eso de mí. Yo creo que me gusta más que la gente lo diga y que la gente se dé cuenta poco a poco y yo hacer mi trabajo nada más en el cuadrilátero.
Now, to answer your question, it's, you know, right now my focus is 100% only on Austin Trout, and that's all I'm thinking of. You know, after the fight, we'll sit down, discuss what's next, but right now I'm focused only on Austin Trout and, God willing, winning this fight. And as for your second question, it's an honor. I'm very, very honored to hear someone like Oscar mention me in those words. And I love it. It does fill me, but, you know, I rather the people say it and me continue to do my job inside the ring.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Hello, everybody. Robert, could you ask Canelo, you know, going into this fight, when the deal was being done, I guess there was people that were on his camp that weren't really high on the fight, but that Canelo himself continued to press for because it was a fight that he personally wanted to sort of prove a lot of the critics wrong and just to you know, say maybe he hadn't really fought any top fighters to take on one of the elite fighters in the junior middleweight division. Can he talk about, you know, his mindset as far as demanding that fight and maybe going against what some of his advisors and people close to him thought about the matchup?
Canelo, la pregunta es que inicialmente cuando se propuso esta pelea, cuando se empezó a negociar esta pelea, pues parte de tu equipo estaba en contra de la pelea, pero que tú insististe en pelear con Trout, que tú querías demostrar al público, a la gente, a la prensa, que tú estabas para esto y para cosas mayores. ¿Qué fue lo que realmente pensaste y cómo es que llegaste a esta conclusión?
Bueno, pues en sí todo mi equipo estábamos de acuerdo, estábamos queriendo, cuando decidimos esa pelea, cuando le ganó a Cotto, pues todo el equipo estábamos de acuerdo, ¿no? Ya lo hablamos con nuestro equipo también, Golden Boy, y pues también empezaron a trabajar en eso y yo creo que lo importante es que el equipo, todo el equipo esté de acuerdo en algo, ¿no?
Yeah, you know, Dan, the team, we were, after the fight with Cotto, we had decided that's the fight we wanted. And yes, we sat down and talked to our promoters, Golden Boy, made the decision. That was who we wanted. They got to work, and that's where we're at now, and we're all happy that we're all in agreement.
But am I wrong, Robert, that there were people, at least initially, that were, you know, not, I mean, they were going to do what Canelo ultimately wanted them to do, but that they weren't really pressing the issue. They thought maybe there could be a different fight from or a better fight, but that Canelo himself insisted on this fight.
Well, yeah, it was brought up that, you know, hey, there's other fights, let's take other avenues, but Canelo wanted this fight. And, you know, that's why we're here on this call today and with the fight coming up on the 20th.
Could you ask him then, does he view this? I mean, he's been a champion now for a while. He's fought some good fighters and that sort of thing and been active. But does he view this as his best opponent and also sort of like, I guess, maybe his moment of truth to sort of prove to anybody that might doubt his abilities that he is for real because he's taken on one of the best fighters out there, you know, coming off the win against Cotto?
Saul, ¿crees que esta pelea realmente es la pelea más dura de tu carrera? Has sido campeón ya mucho tiempo, has defendido, estás invicto, pero ¿crees que esta es la pelea que realmente le va a demostrar a todo el público que aún critica o aún habla que Canelo sí es el mejor en la división o de los mejores en el box?
Yo creo que la crítica es constructiva y la crítica siempre va a haber, pero sin duda pues siempre la pelea que viene es la más importante, es la más difícil. Esta es mi pelea en turno y es la más difícil, claro que sí.
Dan, there's always going to be critics, but criticism is also constructive.